Hello, this is session number 6, and in today's session we are going to discuss project management process areas. So in previous session we have discussed all the process management process areas, and now in today's session we are going to discuss the project management process areas. Now the project management process areas cover the project management activities related to planning, monitoring and controlling of the project. Now there are 7 project management process areas in CMMI development. The first is integrated project management, IPM. Second is project monitoring and control, PMC. Third is project planning, PP. Fourth is quantitative project management, QPM. Fifth is requirements management, REQM. Sixth is risk management, RSKM. And seventh is supplier agreement management, SAM. Now the basic project management process areas address the activities related to establishing and maintaining the project plan, establishing and maintaining the commitments, monitoring the progress against the plan, and taking corrective actions for managing the overall project. It also looks into supplier agreements. Now this diagram provides a bird's eye view of the interactions among the basic project management process areas with other process area categories. The project planning process area includes developing the project plan, involving relevant stakeholders, obtaining commitment to the plan and maintaining the plan. Now the planning begins with requirements that define the product and the project both. The project plan covers the various project management and development activities which are performed by the project. The project reviews other plans that affect the project from various relevant stakeholders and establishes commitments with those stakeholders for their contributions of the to the project. Now, for example, these plans cover configuration management, verification, measurement and analysis, and a lot of other things. The project monitoring and control process area contains practices for monitoring and controlling activities and taking corrective actions. Now, the project plan specifies the frequency of the progress or the progress reviews and the measure used to monitor the progress, how that progress will be reviewed. The progress is determined primarily by comparing project status with the project plan. Now, when the actual status deviates significantly from the expected values or corrective proper plan, the corrective actions are taken to overcome those deviations. Now, these actions can include replanning, which requires using of project planning practices. The requirements management process areas maintain the requirements only. It describes activities for obtaining and controlling requirements or the requirement changes and ensuring that other relevant plans and data are kept current. It provides traceability of the requirements from the customer requirements to the product requirements and up to the even product component requirements. So the requirements management ensure that changes to requirements are reflected in project plans, activities, and also in work products. Now, this cycle of changes can affect the engineering process areas also. Thus, requirements management is a dynamic and often recursive sequence of events. So, the requirements management process area is fundamental to a controlled and disciplined engineering process also. Now, the supplier agreement management, SAM. This process area addresses the need of the project to acquire those portions of the work that are produced by the suppliers, outsiders, third party. Now the sources of products that can be used to satisfy project requirements are proactively identified. The supplier is selected and a supplier agreement is established to manage the supplier. The supplier's progress and the performance are tracked as specified in the supplier agreement, and the supplier agreement is revised on timely basis. Acceptance reviews and tests are conducted on the supplier produced product components. This always happens. Now we'll talk about the advanced project management process areas. Now these areas address activities such as establishing a defined process that is tailored from the organization's set of standard processes, establishing the project work environment from the organization's work environment standards, coordinating and collaborating with relevant stakeholders, forming and sustaining teams for the conduct of projects, quantitatively managing the project and managing the risk. Now the diagram provides a bird's eye view of the interactions among the advanced project management process areas with other process area categories. Each advanced project management process area depends on the ability to plan, monitor, and control the project. The basic project management process areas provide this ability. The integrated project management process, IPM, this establishes and maintains the project's defined process that is tailored from the organization's set of standard processes, which you can get from organizational process definition, OPD. The project is managed using the project's defined process. The project uses and contributes to the organizational process assets. The project's work environment is established and maintained from the organization's work environment standards, and the teams are established using the organization's rules and guidelines. The project's relevant stakeholders coordinate their efforts in a timely manner through the identification, negotiation, and tracking of critical dependencies and the resolution of coordination issues. Although risk identification and monitoring are covered in project planning and project monitoring and control process areas, the risk management process area takes a continuing forward-looking approach to managing the risks with activities that include identification of risk parameters, risk assessment, and risk mitigation plans. The quantitative project management process areas, these areas establishes objectives for quality and process performance. It composes a defined process that can help achieve those objectives and quantitatively manage the project. The project's quality and the process performance objectives are based on objectives established by the organization and the customer. Now, the project's defined process is composed using statistical and other quantitative techniques, such as such an analysis enables the project to predict whether it will achieve its quality and process performance objectives or not. Based on the predictions, the project can adjust the defined process or can negotiate changes to quality and process performance objectives. As the project progresses, the performance of selected sub-processes is carefully monitored to help the evaluate whether the project is on track, whether the project is achieving its objectives or not. So this is end of session number 6, where we have discussed the project management process areas, in which we have discussed the process areas related to IPM, PMC, PP, QPM, REQM, RSKM, SAM. And we have discussed the basic project management process areas and their interaction, and advanced project management process areas and their interaction.